work in a soup kitchen. Have you ever prepared meals for homeless folks, either through Housing Forward, the PADS program, or some other? Have you ever done something that got you out of your comfort zone, that made a difference in another person's life? Pilgrim intentionally lifts up the fourth Thursday of every month to be the time when many of the folks who are involved with Pilgrim will go over to First United Methodist Church here in Oak Park and prepare food, prepare dinner, and serve it, set up pads for people to sleep on and blankets. They will prepare breakfast for them in the morning, and they will give them a sack lunch to take with them during the day so that they have nourishment throughout the day. I know that many of you have done that work. And it is work. When I've done it, it has felt, I have felt humbled and grateful and awkward. And I'm not doing anything more than plating food and putting it on a table and saying hello to someone I don't know. I'm not doing anything other than what I am able to do. And yet, it's not something I do every day. And so it feels awkward. And yet, it makes a difference in people's lives. A couple weeks ago, I gathered with some other faith leaders at Housing Forward and the breakfast that they were having for us to remind us of the work they're doing and to thank us for the work that our congregations do to make a difference in people's lives. And one of the things that was most uplifting to me was the commitment that Housing Forward has always had, not just to give someone a bed for the night, but to end homelessness. Not because we're going to close our eyes and pretend there aren't homeless people, but because they believe that there are ways in which we can make sure that everyone has a secure place to live, not just sleep tonight and move tomorrow and sleep that night and move the next day, but a place to live, a place that gives them security, bringing about the realm of God here and now, not through miracles, but through thoughtful work and pulling resources together that make a difference. I don't know if, because I'm not sitting in your living room, I don't know how many of you had the opportunity to see the article that was on the front page of the Tribune on Thanksgiving Day. I have to say, I was thankful, because I knew I'd be talking about it this morning. I knew what the text was. So it's this story about this woman who has created an opportunity. She calls it the kitchen table. It's a not-for-profit where people pay what they can. And it's done with a great deal of respect and thought. She started this, it's just outside Rochelle, about 90 miles west of Chicago. And she started this a year and a half ago and served 175 people the first night they were open. They now are serving about 125 on a regular basis. They are open on Tuesday and Thursday evenings from 4:30 to 7:30. And what happens is that people come in and they sit at a table, any table. It's not a huge place, but they sit at a table. And a greeter comes to them and says, "So Evelyn, what would you like for dinner tonight? Here are your choices." And there are several choices, several main courses, and several options for vegetables and dessert and stuff like that. They take the order, and off they go, and they come back and bring the food, and everyone gets to eat. And people are eating together. It doesn't matter where they came from, they're all eating together. And when the meal is over, the greeter comes and brings them one of those vinyl bill things, so it's inside the bill, and inside the vinyl thing, hands it to Evelyn. And Evelyn can open it up and will hear about, read about what this restaurant does. They ask people to pay what they can, and if that means they pay nothing, that's okay. If it means that they're pretty flush that day and they want to pay extra money, they can do that too. But it all goes into that final thing. They also have information about how to volunteer. They now have 700 volunteers. 700 volunteers in Rochelle. Way up, Rochelle probably doesn't have 700 people. Okay. 700 volunteers who are invited. And not only are they doing this feeding people and having them pay whatever they can afford to pay, they're also delivering food to shelters, to domestic violence shelters, to a men's shelter, to a senior living facility. They are creating a scholarship fund. They're doing this incredibly wonderful thing. They're not walking on water. They are not waving a wand and making something magic happen. They're just doing what human beings can do. They're just working together to make a difference. This organization participates with a global organization called One World Everybody Eats. This lovely piece of paper, which I've printed off, is in the back. You can pick it up. Or you can Google One World Everybody Eats and you'll find out information about it. Food insecurity affects 800 million people, 800 million people globally, including 17 million households in every county in the United States, every county in the United States. There are now more than 60 pay-what-you-can community cafes operating in this country, and over 50 others in the planning stages in six countries. Jesus came to tell us that there's work to be done, that the realm of God is right here. Right here. It's not down the road. It's not coming in a year. It's not coming in 100 years. It is right here. And it's here because each of us has the capacity to make a difference each day. Whether it's smiling at somebody who looks a little down, but not forcing them to smile back, because it's okay not to smile. It's saying hello to somebody and recognizing that they are present. It is creating community for each of us, for all of us. It is making sure that no one is left out. It is making sure that those who might be afraid to take a step are being accompanied by someone who's willing to walk with them. It's not rocket science. It is what human beings have the capacity to do every day. Now, yes, in the story we have this thing about these goats and these sheep, so let me go back to that just a little bit. This is written in the Gospel of Matthew. It is a story that Matthew is telling to help people understand that, you know what, we are this close in this story to Jesus' death. The very nice next chapter, we step right into the Passion. Hello, we're there. And Matthew is going, oh my God, I'm almost done. What do I need to say to get people to understand? In the time when this was written, at least a generation, if not two generations after Jesus died, and the way the group of people following in Jesus' footsteps, the way was pretty much engaged in the synagogue. And the synagogue was feeling frustrated. But you're telling different stories. And so they were kind of separating themselves out. And it's kind of like the Beatitudes. You remember the Beatitudes, blessed are the poor. Now, someone can hear that as, why would Jesus tell me I'm blessed to be poor? That's not the message. The message is that poor people, hungry people, grieving people, have always been given the message that they are out of luck, that they are losers, that they're not okay. And this one comes along and says, no, we're going to turn it upside down. It doesn't mean that it feels wonderful to be poor. It doesn't mean that it feels wonderful to be hungry. It doesn't mean that it feels wonderful to be grieving. No. But do know that God loves you no matter what. So this one in the Gospel of Matthew is about to finish the work. And Matthew's eager to tell the story that will help people go, oh, I get it. And this isn't about, if you do this, you will go to heaven. No, this is about the realm of God here and now. When you feed the hungry, when you work in pads, even in the middle of the night, and you might be tired, there's something that happens inside of you that feels right, that feels connected. You know you didn't walk on water. You probably drove to First United Methodist Church. And no, you didn't get to sleep through the night. Or no, you didn't get to have dinner with your family. Or no, you weren't there for breakfast. But you were in this place. And what you did made a difference. That's the realm of God. Here and now. It's being present to each other. It's doing what we can do, knowing that if we're all doing something, it will make a difference. Housen Fogel believes that they can, in fact, with our help and the help of many people and homelessness. Carolyn Brown, the woman who created the kitchen table, wants to make sure that people are fed. And she isn't doing it alone. She's doing it with that 700 volunteers. She's doing it with an incredible number of donors who are giving food and giving services. She is not alone. None of us are alone. And together, we help bring about the realm of God in this place. And we celebrate. We celebrate the one who came to show us how to do this, to remind us that each of us can make a difference. And on this day, we are reminded of the gifts we've been